Hello everyone, I, Sarabala, hereby presents you my research in video format. Insight into Indian Occupational Therapy Practices, published in IJSR Volume 10, Issue 9. We shall be starting with what is occupational therapy. In a very simplistic manner, we can say that it's a health profession which is person-centric and is concerned with promoting health and well-being through enabling participation and engagement in everyday life activities across the lifespan of an individual. Introducing OT in India, it started in the year 1952. Since then, it has seen a lot of growth in academia as well as legislation. However, it still struggles to get its due credit and recognition. The research was done in a single-phase cross-sectional survey design with convenience sampling. Over 1,700 occupational therapy professionals or OTPs were contacted and were frequently reminded to participate in survey for 2 months. The survey collected responses in 3 sections, comprising of 29 questions in total. Collecting information such as demographics, practicing areas, documentation, availability and approachability, and administrative policies. For compiling results, SPSS along with Microsoft Excel and Microsoft Forms were used. Only 56 participants fulfilled the inclusion criteria whose responses were included for analytical purpose in the study. The respondents covered 44% of Indian subcontinent. On an average, it took just 1 second short of 13 minutes to respond to all questions. As per the survey, OT distribution across the entities showed hospital and academia fields being ruled by females, whereas school setups being more male dominant, although an equal distribution was marked for entrepreneurship. Coming on to gender-wise distribution, for domains or practices, males opted for pediatrics, rehabilitation and disability, and work and industry, whereas female could be seen working in almost every domain. Domain practice earlier in career versus currently practicing change showed male population being growing in almost every domain except academia. Nearly 57% of respondents were contradicted by other professionals while delivering the appropriate services to their clients. And about 63% of OTPs refrained from changing their domain of practice even if they are provided with better opportunities. For ranking treatment strategies opted by OTPs, group therapy was ranked as least frequently used strategy, whereas neuromuscular education and re-education was ranked as the chiefly used strategy for treating clients, even across the experience group. Irrespective of the specialization and qualifications, most of OTPs were working in pediatric domain, followed by rehabilitation and disability. SOAP notes and standardized assessments were preferred method for documentation across types of entities, along with responses for not documenting as they were either not mandatory by their institutes or lack of time to document, lack of support, and encouragement from institutes were received as primary reasons for not documenting. The condition of governmental setups were reported to be best in ADL training labs and work hardening and conditioning labs, while being worst in play areas and sprinting or AT units. The private setup were better with play and leisure areas, and so were the NGOs. No one reported work hardening or conditioning unit from NGO sector. other than their institute, most of the respondents marked that OT services are available within 5 kilometers of their block, except few locations in states of Karnataka, Maharashtra, Orissa, Uttar Pradesh, and Uttarakhand. A similar response was noted in district-wise distribution. However, when analyzing distribution in various states except Delhi, Haryana, Kerala, Maharashtra, and Uttar Pradesh, rest of India have to travel more than 30 kilometers to get OT services. 78.5% of OTPs across the country felt the scarcity and lacunae in availability and provision of occupational therapy equipment and prescription aid within their region. The ratio dips to 76.7% when asked about the same at pan-India level, and plunges further to 44.6% when queried for the same at online level, supported with 34% who couldn't be sure enough for their responses. In section 3 of the survey, the respondents were asked whether the institute where they work has clearly defined roles for an OTP and physical therapist. In response, just 55% responded a confirmative yes, and 11% responded that the question is not applicable at their work. On a lighter note, institutes had much better defined roles between an occupational therapy practitioner and a special educator. When asked about the extent that colleagues differentiate between the roles of OTP and physical therapist, the responses were staggering. Only 34% of respondents felt that the people at their respective institutes can clearly identify the roles between both the professions to somewhat or larger extent, whereas only 30% felt that their colleagues can clearly identify the roles of an OTP and special educator. Just 25% of respondents felt that to some extent the OT department services are provided with equal or better opportunities for upgradation as related professions in their organization. Similarly, 25% of OTP felt that OT department is given equal or more importance as related department in administrative decision making. Coming to limitations of the study, as per author, firstly, the ongoing pandemic situation would have resulted in low responses. Also, the timeline during which the research was performed was the peak period of stress for the nation during the pandemic. Secondly, the length of survey and no option to save responses as drafts could have impacted the number of responses. Thirdly, because of lack of national registry for occupational therapy professionals, including their specialty and area of practice, not every occupational therapy professional could be reached out. Lastly, coming to discussion and conclusion, as per the Indian population, the need and demand of an OTP is massive. However, skewness of OTPs across pediatric and rehabilitation and disability has restricted the growth of profession across other domains. The introduction of occupational therapy assistant post in Indian context by major stakeholders such as IJSR and various state councils can prove beneficial for future OTPs as well as the profession per se. Concluding the research paper, all the stakeholders have to find out a way for marketing the profession and increase the opportunities for all the practicing domains and not limit to only few. Stakeholders should consider upgrading minimum entry level standards of practice and introduce OT assistant posts and make India stand congruent to the world. also supporting implementation of upcoming WFOT's Quality Indicator Framework Manual. Considering IOTA as the only representational body for occupational therapy professionals recognized by Government of India, IOTA needs to develop more faith and have transparent approach towards its members and data availability on its website. Also, should conduct regular dialogue with all its members as well as the various agencies required for legislative changes. Thank you.